A very warm welcome everyone. My name is Harshita and today we will discuss about the intrinsic mechanism of apoptosis. In the last video, we have discussed about the mechanism of apoptosis. In that, we have seen that how a death signal causes the activation of the caspases leading to the death of the cell. Now, the death signal can follow two pathways. One is the extrinsic pathway and the second one is the intrinsic pathway. We have already finished the extrinsic pathway in the previous video. So if you haven't watched it yet, I have shared the link in the I button as well as in the description box. Check the video from there. Now we will talk about the intrinsic pathway of the apoptosis. So just like the extrinsic mechanism, in the intrinsic mechanism, there is also a death signal, also called as the apoptotic signal. Now this death signal is actually from the inside of the cell and it will cause the activation of certain types of the proteins which actually favors the apoptosis, or you can say it initiates or activates the intrinsic pathway leading to the apoptosis of the cell. So now the question arises, what are these death signals which activate the intrinsic pathway? The second question is, what are these proteins which get activated by the death signal and how they will cause the activation of the intrinsic pathway? The third question is, what is intrinsic pathway and what are its steps? So we will see these questions in this video. Now, what are the death signals in the intrinsic pathway, or the death signals which can trigger the death of the cell by the intrinsic mechanism? So number one is the DNA damage. DNA damage occurs in response to the radiation or the chemotherapy. It will lead to the accumulation of a protein called as a P53. Now this P53 protein will cause the apoptosis by the activation of the proteins. Now the another one is the ER stress, that is the endoplasmic reticulum stress, and this stress is because of the misfolding of the proteins, and this will lead to the ER stress and leading to the death of the cell. The number third is the lack of survival factors. Now every cell needs a survival factor for remaining alive. If there is absence of such factors, the cell will undergo the process of apoptosis. Like the nerve needs nerve growth factor. Or another example is example of shedding of endometrium during every menstrual cycle. So there is shedding of endometrium because there is lack of hormone called as the progesterone, which is required for its growth. So these are the death signals. Now the second question is, what are the proteins which are involved in the intrinsic mechanism? So the whole process of the intrinsic mechanism is mediated as well as regulated by the BCL2 family of the proteins. And this BCL2 family of proteins basically contains three different classes of the proteins. Number one is the anti-apoptotic proteins, that is BCL2, BCL-XL. Second one is pro-apoptotic proteins, BARC and BUX. Number three is the BH3 sensors, that is BAD, BIM, PUMA and NOXA. So what is anti-apoptotic protein? Anti means against. So these proteins are against the process of apoptosis and they will inhibit the process of apoptosis. The second one is pro-apoptotic, means it will favor the process of apoptosis. And number three is a BH3 sensors that will actually detect the damage in the cell and cause the apoptosis. Now the next question is, how these proteins will work and how they cause the activation of the intrinsic pathway. Now in this slide, there is a comparison between a normal cell and a damaged cell. So in a normal cell, you can see there is no DNA damage, there is no ER stress and there is presence of the survival factors. So as you can see, there is no death signal to the cell. So what happened in response to that? In response to that, there will be increase in the synthesis of the proteins which are against the process of apoptosis because it is not required. So the anti-apoptotic proteins will be more, and these are BCL2 and BCL-XL. Now what does this anti-apoptotic proteins will do? They will bind to the pro-apoptotic protein and inhibit the process of the apoptosis. Now looking at the damaged cell. In the damaged cell, there is a damage to the cell. There could be a DNA damage or a ER stress or a lack of survival factor. All this act as a death signal or the apoptotic signal to the cell. And this death signal will be detected by the BH3 sensors proteins, which will then cause the activation of the pro-apoptotic proteins favoring the apoptosis and inhibiting the anti-apoptotic proteins, that is the BCL2 and BCL-XL. Okay, so in a normal cell, there is inhibition of the pro-apoptotic but a activation of the anti-apoptotic proteins. But in a damaged cell, there is opposite. There will be activation of the pro-apoptotic proteins and there will be inhibition of the anti-apoptotic proteins. Now, next slide will give us more clarity regarding the concept. Okay, so here you can see there is a normal cell and there is a damaged cell again. So in a normal cell, there is synthesis of the pro-apoptotic proteins called as the BCL2 and BCL-XL. This anti-apoptotic protein will go and bind to the pro-apoptotic protein called as a BAC on the outer mitochondrial membrane. As a result, the permeability of the outer membrane of the mitochondria will remain unchanged. But in a damaged cell, the BH3 sensors will detect the damage, they will inhibit the anti-apoptotic proteins, and thus they will be not able to bind to the pro-apoptotic proteins on the outer membrane of the mitochondria. So this pro-apoptotic proteins will form a oligomer and they will actually form a channel like. And from this channel, the substance which is present in the intermembrane space of the mitochondria will come out and it is now in the cytoplasm. So by this means we can see there is increase in the permeability of the outer membrane of the mitochondria. So we have discussed about the death signals. We have talked about the proteins involved in it and how they work, how they affect the permeability of the mitochondria. Now will we look at the steps of the intrinsic pathway of the apoptosis. So this is also called as a mitochondrial mechanism of apoptosis because mitochondria has a central role in this mechanism. We know it is a remarkable organelle as it contains various proteins. And what such protein is basically cytochrome C. So we have this red color structure as cytochrome C, which is present in the intermembrane space of the mitochondria. And this cytochrome C basically has a very crucial role in this pathway. So now we can understand the intrinsic pathway as follows. So what death signal has came, and this death signal, as we have seen in the previous slide, that it will cause the inhibition of the anti-apoptotic and let the pro-apoptotic proteins called as the BAC to form an oligomer, and from this channel formed by this BAC, the cytochrome C will come out from the intermembrane space of the mitochondria into the cytoplasm. The cytochrome C has came out from the intermembrane space of the mitochondria into the cytoplasm. Now this cytochrome C will bind to the another adapter protein present in the cytoplasm called as the apoptotic protease activating factor 1. the cytochrome C will bind to this adaptor protein. This adaptor protein also contains a domain called as the caspase re-recruitment domain. Now the binding of the cytochrome C to the adaptor protein will result in its unfolding and formation of a field-like structure called as the apoptosome, which is actually a heptamer because it consists of the 7 adaptor proteins along with the cytoplasm and along with the cat. So it forms a wheel-like structure called as the apoptosome. Now to this apoptosome, there is binding of the enzyme called as the procaspase 9, which is an initiated caspase in the intrinsic pathway. Now this procaspase 9 will bind to this wheel-like structure, that is the apoptosome, and as a result this procaspase 9 will come in the proximity with the CART, that is the caspase re-recruitment domain, as well as with the other procaspases, and as a result there will be auto cleavage of this procaspases 9 by each other. It will result in the activation of the caspase 9. Now caspase 9 is an initiator caspase, so it will activate the executioner caspase called as the caspase 3. So this is the complete intrinsic mechanism. I will repeat it again, that the cytochrome C will be released from the intermembrane space of the mitochondria into the cytoplasm. It will bind to the adaptor protein called as the apoptotic protease activating factor 1. This will result in the formation of a wheel-like structure called as the apoptosome. Now to this apoptosome, the procaspase 9 will bind and it will come in proximity with the CART as well as with the other procaspases 9, resulting in the activation of it, and this caspase 9 will activate the caspase 3. So we have discussed all the three questions: what are death signals, what are the proteins involved in the intrinsic mechanism, and what are the steps in the intrinsic mechanism. So now we will have a quick revision of this slide. So number one is, there will be a death signal which will come, DNA damage, ER stress, lack of survival factor. The BH3 sensor protein will detect the damage. It will activate pro-apoptotic proteins and inhibit the synthesis of the anti-apoptotic proteins. The bark will form oligomers at the outer mitochondrial membrane, resulting in the increase in the permeability of the outer membrane of the mitochondria. There will be release of cytochrome C from the intermembrane space of mitochondria into the cytosol. Cytochrome C will bind to the adaptor protein called as the apoptotic protease activating factor 1, which also contains the caspase re-recruitment domain. This will form a field-like structure called as the apoptosome. CART will occupy the central hub of the apoptosome. CART will bind to specific domain of procaspase 9 in the apoptosome. This allows procaspases to come in proximity and thus they will autocleave each other. Lastly, active caspase 9 will activate caspase 3, resulting in the death of the cell. Now this is an assignment to all of you. You have to write in the fill in the blanks of both these pathways. Don't forget to write your answers in the comment section. These are the references you can look forward for the same topic. In the upcoming videos, we will talk about what will happen to these apoptotic bodies, and we will also start a separate series of cardiovascular physiology. Till then, keep learning.